And I've been so pleasured to give a talk on this holistic approach in weight management and diabetic control. And regarding, I think, ma'am, you covered maximum of my slides. But anyway, I just want to talk on a diabetic thing.
Diabetic part, yes. You're the diabetologist, right person to discuss for diabetic patients what they,
of course,
they should not.
Shall I start, ma'am?
Yes, of course.
Yeah.
The stage is all yours.
Yeah. I think slides are visible, ma'am.
Yes, visible. Yeah. Make full.
Of course, okay. I think ma'am has covered everything nicely regarding the weight and diet and about food things and about exercise. I think so I can just move on to my completely on diabetic part. So here, regarding the weight management, every human being is the author of his own health and disease. Because nowadays in diabetic peoples, we have been start treating the patient with the precision diabetes. Because everyone knows that each and every individual is different. Not everyone is same. So if you start treating them, some kind of drugs works for like metformin works to beautifully some person. Metformin doesn't work to people who are having gastritis. So each and every individual is different in this issue. Regarding as weight management and diabetic control, we should be more particularly on the diet and also the exercise plays as a major role. So if you start taking a diet and exercise, they are both are the parallel things. It has to be taken care when this both has to be in the same manner. So diet and exercise has to be you should daily watch and has to be taken care for the longer time. So as obesity, if you start as a metabolic disorder, so it is an increased risk of diabetes, hypertension, coronary artery disease. If you take a metabolic disorder, it is a change which happens in your body for a longer period. So if it is longer period, if you're not taking care about your diet and your physical activity, so it all leads to metabolic disorder. When metabolic disorder happens, our body decreases to start our insulin. So when the insulin starts decreasing, so you may end up with diabetic. If you start taking the diabetic tablets and other kind of tablets, it leads to hypertension, or the both hypertension and diabetes will lead to coronary artery disease and other types of, we can't say as a cancer, because nowadays stress plays a major role in inducing the cancer. There are the many more papers we have been seeing. The stress has been the culprit which leads to cancer. So, but already madam has covered on stress management, yoga and meditation. Madam has covered nicely. So these are the things has to be taken care of. So if you start targeting on the metabolic thing, like obesity and weight management and the diet, definitely the increased risk of diabetes, hypertension, and coronary artery disease can be reduced. So it gives us the quality of life, and also the life expectancy will be higher side. So if you're not being more concerned on the metabolic disorder, so it's keep on building up. If you start keep on building up your weight, if you're not taking care about the physical activity and mental stress. So these are the changes which leads to metabolic disorder. So we have to be taken care about the metabolic disorder along with the obesity, which are the risk factors for diabetic, hypertension, and coronary artery disease.
Dr. Rakesh, sorry for the interview. Yes, see, can you make full screen?
There's
hourglass, you'll have to click on that to make it full screen. The below, if you click on the full screen, there's one cup like thing. You press on the cup like icon, it will become full screen. Cup icon.
Just a minute. Full screen.
Below there's a cup icon, cup like icon. Are you able to see that?
It's great. screen.
There's a cup like icon which you
yes,
go down. Ah, yes. Go down and press on that.
I could not see it, ma'am.
Not seeing it? Only you can do. I cannot do it, or even Kritika can't do it. If you go down and press on the cup like icon, down it is for hourglass or cup mari irukum.
Dr. Mohan
if you put function F5, good, super. Function F5 also will help, but you'll have to go subsequently to the slide you want. Yeah, correct.
Unmute, doctor, please unmute.
Yes, ma'am. This is the main culprit regarding, as I said earlier, it's a metabolic disorder is the main culprit which leads to other risk factors like diabetes, hypertension, coronary artery disease, and cancer. So if you start focusing on the metabolic disorder like obesity and weight management and regarding the food and we are intaking and the stress management, it leads to you give the quality of life and the life expectancy will be more. So this is the main thing and main culprit we have to take. I think this madam has clearly said about this pear-shaped and apple-shaped body. If like a male, it starts with along the abdominal visceral obesity in the upper part. The female, it has a pear shape. But the apple-shaped body, which is the obesity, which creates a higher risk of cardiovascular disorder, hypertension, and diabetes. But the pear shape also causes a major problem regarding the other kind of joint pain and leads to cancer, other kind of obesity-related problems. But moreover, the apple shape has the severity and also it has some more risk of diabetes and hypertension. If you take the central obesity, high blood pressure, high triglyceride, and low level of HDL and insulin resistance, which all caused with metabolic syndromes. So I think if I said like obesity, if 18 to 24, it's a normal. If 25 to 29, it's overweight. If it is above 30, it's definitely it's obesity. So we have to more focus on when we start off our BMI, it is 24, we have to take care. So it's the right time. So if you keep on going to overweight, then it leads to obesity. So at that time, it takes a very longer period and very difficult for you people. Or if you're a guy or a male, female, or if she's a 40 or 50. So you have to start measuring your BMI. If it is 24 to 26, better, okay, you can be a normal person. If it is keep on changing, it leads to 30 or above 30, then it will be very, very, very difficult to come over to 20 or 24. So start approaching when you are mid 26 or 27. It's the right time to make sure you have to do proper exercise and proper food diet. So when you start taking a calorie, if as a ma'am, everything has been covered. If you take if you're planning per day, if you take breakfast, lunch, or tea or dinner, you are consuming a 7,000 calorie. It leads to a per kg, 1 kg, 1 kg per 7,000 kilogram. So if you are not been doing a proper exercise or diet, it tends to building upon your fat. It leads to resulting in consumption of 7,000 calorie in a day. So it keep on adding to your daily activities. It keep on tends to increase your 1 kg per day. So however, the people may not know if 17 hours takes to burn a calorie of 7,000 calorie and 35 hours of walking, it takes to burn 7,000 calorie and 7 hours of running. So these are the swimming and walking, which are burn 7,000 calorie per day. So if there is an imbalance between the calorie intake and the what you intake on what you practice or what you play or what you swim or jockey, so if there is an imbalance, it leads to obesity. When the obesity occurs, you start gaining of weight. So that you should make sure that the intake of calorie of food should be in a proper way. And also the output of calorie and output of the energy also should be in the balanced way. If there is an imbalance between the what the calorie you take and what the weight or energy you lost, if there is an imbalance, then there is a problem. It leads to metabolic imbalance. So this metabolic imbalance, as I said, the obesity is the main culprit. It obesity leads to your metabolic imbalance. It definitely causes diabetes, high cholesterol, high blood pressure, and also hormonal imbalance. the low level of cholesterol, anxiety, cancer and asthma and sleep disorder. So these are the examples we have been saying, but the obesity, which may leads to other hormonal diabetes or high cholesterol, it leads to some of the major cardiovascular risk factors. If patients start having diabetes, it leads to high cholesterol. If the high cholesterol leads to myocardial infarction or cardiovascular death. If the high blood pressure leads to stroke. So these are the things, these are the complication and life-threatening condition when patient going to suffer of obesity. So how to reduce the weight? See, there are the three kind of things has been in the modern science, like a lifestyle modification, pharmacotherapy and surgery. If you stay off lifestyle modification, diet and physical activity, which plays a major role. So when we start off walking, you have to be walk at least per 1 hour per day, and you have to be more cautious on diet. If you start reducing 400 calorie per day in your each meal, as ma'am said, as 2,800 calorie a person consuming a day, if you start reducing 400 calories per day, along with the hour of exercise, it definitely leads to weight reduction. If you start reducing the weight, if you start reducing your intake, definitely there is a big change in diabetes and hypertension and other cardiovascular like cholesterol and other things. So these are the lifestyle modification. If for example, you have to be, if you start dieting, there should be no sugars, there should be no smoking, no alcohol, and other kind of thing. So if you take a diet part, some of my patients say, sir, I'm doing a 1 hour walking, I'm not reducing weight. No, you can't lose your weight if you're starting off 1 hour walking. In 1 hour walking, you should have at least a half an hour of resistance exercise and half an hour of flexibility like bending and stretching and this kind of thing. And half an hour of walking or jogging. So at least 1.5 hours a patient should spend on physical activity. Along with that, at least they have to reduce the 400 calorie or 500 calorie per day. So if you are not combining these two things, like I said, it's a parallel way. It's a parallel thing. It's by side by side. If you start dieting, if you start physical activity, then you can see a better result of reducing your diabetes, hypertension, and also cholesterol level and other kind of thing. But if you're not balancing the two things, if you're not doing exercise, If I'm doing diet, I'm not doing physical activity. No, you can't achieve your blood sugar levels under control. So these are the things to have to be in the panel way. So like pharmacotherapies, there are the many drugs which has been available in the market, like diuretics, metformin, and SGLT2. These are the latest drugs which has been available in the market. But each and every drug has its own side effects. If you start metformin, it will reduce your weight, but it contains lactic acidosis. Sometimes patient may end up with gastritis and other kind of renal impairment. If you're taking off SGLT2, it is a better drug. It reduces the weight drastically. And also it has some kind of renal impairment. So it's also advisable. If you start taking diuretics in many, there are the latest products which has been available in the market. They have been saying this kind of powder will reduce your weight level. No, you can't believe that. What is the thing it's happening in the powder or in the other kind of thing which has been consumed daily? So you should start knowing what you are consuming and what you are taking in the daily food or the pharmacotherapy. So the level of the drugs which are being start reducing your weight, there are some side effects which leads to other kind of risk factors in the cardiovascular, in the heart, in the kidney. So you have to be more keen on that. Let's start surgery. Anyway, Dr. Paniappan is going to talk about surgery like bariatric surgery. It's a surgery. They're reducing the stomach size. So the food you take to dinner or lunch, it will be reduced. So the major meal will be reduced by cutting your stomach into C-shape or trimming your stomach into small size. So when we start trimming your stomach or your duodenum or a small intestine, so the food intake that will be reduced. So if the intake of food is reduced, there will be a lot of weight reduction can be seen, and also the insulin dose can be reduced. The drugs which you have been consuming daily, I can see many patients who have been taking 15 to 20 pills per day, and the patients consuming 150 units per day. So when they go for bariatric surgery, they feel drastic and miracle weight reduction, at least 30 kilo per month. But it has to be maintained. If you start reducing, if the weight has been reduced initially, like 1 to 6 months, but when you start dieting and also the drugs can be reduced and the physical activity has to be maintained after the surgery. So if you start maintaining this both three, definitely the weight has to be in the normal stage. If you're not following that, after 6 months or after the 1 year or 2 years, definitely the weight can be against restarting or remission of weight can be done. So everywhere, it has to be a longer period, not a shorter period. Like I said, in the diet, like our DG has initially asked the question of keto diet. Yeah, definitely the keto diet is working amazing. But the keto diet, for how long you're going to take the chicken or mutton for a year? Or how long you can going to take the butter? It will. I've seen many patients who have been reduced with the keto diet. They have been taking insulin 100 units or 150 units. Suddenly they lost 30 kilos and they stopped insulin and they have been free from the drugs. But if you start measuring your cholesterol level and your blood pressure, no. The sugar can be reduced, or you if you start reducing your weight, definitely there will be changes in your other parameters. But think about the cholesterol level and think about your artery. The triglyceride will be in the higher limit. If you start taking butter or daily chicken, how long you are going to take? So it directly affects about the cardiovascular system. But there will be more improvement in the diabetes, but it won't help in the longer period. So some may end up with the gastritis because how long the chicken or some spicy food or the butter, it definitely leads to some kind of other problems. So you should more care about in the longer period, not in the shorter period. Like I said, again, Riji asked about the sugars. Yeah, you can. My patients, I sometimes used to advise patients to take some kind of sugar-free, or sometimes they used to have, sir, can I ask, sir, can I have a single spoon of sugar? No. If for HbA1c, if your fasting and postprandial is controlled, then you can go for a half spoon of sugar. If your HbA1c is not controlled, your fasting is not controlled, if you are not on the good diet or other physical activity, no, you can't take. And also, the sugar, definitely it can have some kind of, like if you take a half spoon of sugar, it tends to add up for a longer period and it definitely reflects on HbA1c. So these are the things has to be taken care and to be followed. So lifestyle approach. Diet also plays a major role and exercise. Like if you're making a balanced diet, some patients may ask for, sir, what kind of diabetic diet has to be followed? There is no diet called the diabetic diet. It's a balanced diet. So the proportion of carbohydrate has to be reduced from 75% to 25%. To fill up the 50%, you have to add the protein and fibers. As madam already said, in the like good fruits like guava and apple can be consumed. When reducing the 50% of carbohydrate, you have to replace with the vegetables, which can be in the red color or other kind of green color. The vegetable portion should be higher. And to reduce your carbohydrate, it's a balanced diet. In regarding the exercise, it has to be, like I said, three steps, like resistance and flexible and aerobic exercise. The three has to be maintained so that the lifestyle approach will be in the good positions, like nutrition, lifestyle, hydration, breathing, and also you have to be stress-free. So these are the multiple things has to be followed for lifestyle approach. Like dietary management, like you should not skip your breakfast and avoid fat diet, like crash diet. As I said earlier in the keto diet, the fat diet is be the keto diet or some kind of newer things which has been available in the markets, the powders which has been available to reduce your weight. So these can't be work. And crash diet. Sir, I've been going through the intermittent fasting. No, it won't work. How long you are going to be in the intermittent fasting? So these are the trendy weight loss plan, but no, they can't work. These are the fat diets, can't work. So plan on how many servings of fruit, vegetables, whole grain, low fat diet, and other proteins source to include every day. So like I said, you have to be more cautious on carbohydrate, protein, fiber, and also you can add with the nuts, protein, like green peas and other kind of proteins which has been freshly available. So you can include these kind of proteins daily or whole grains. Like if we say in Tamil, Sirudhaniyangal, it will be more healthier. It gives us the high fiber food so that the sugar level will be in the decreased level. So overestimating the calories burnt during the exercise makes to eat and tends to need. At each meal, include one food that is red, as ma'am has already discussed about this. Eat one less bite at each meal can reduce your weight over the year. Drink a lot of water, fill up the stomach, and always read the nutritional label, which has been, if you are going to the supermarket, you can't just go and pick all kind of packed food or tinned foods. You see the label, how much calorie is there, how much of protein is there, how much of carbohydrate is there. So nowadays, every food has been processed. So you have to be more cautious on protein, carbohydrate, and the energy level and the sugar level. So start reading the nutritional label and you start getting it. So that you just avoid all kind of processed or packed food. It gives us a better, go for an organic vegetables, which has been like a green peas, protein, or nuts. It will be good for health. So reduce the salt intake. Salt makes you feel hungry and makes the most processed food with a high in salt content. Choose a healthy plate with adequate amount of carbohydrate, protein, and fat and fiber. Maintain a good food record. So you should be more keen on what you have been taking. So per day, how much calorie you have been consuming. And per meal, if you take a plate, the 25% of plate has been covered with carbohydrates. So there should be a count. So there should be a record. So it gives you the proper record what you have been taking. Chew the food thoroughly and eat slowly. Eat before going to a party, marriage function, or shopping. Like ma'am said, if I'm going to Rotary, I've been waiting for 2 hours. So then your gastritis or the acid secretion in the stomach, it will be very irritating. And you just start consuming more amount of calorie. So when you are going to be a party or a marriage function or a function, just start before going to the party, you start consuming some kind of protein like sundal or some kind of vegetable. So it decreases your gastric level so that you can't go on adding of more food in the functions. So you can take a less kind of food, so it will be less in calorie. So regarding the exercise, if you take the 20 to 40 years, 1 hour of brisk walking, jogging, swimming, and all the stretching, I said, these are the for 20 to 40 years. If you 40 to 60 years, 45 minutes of brisk walking or a normal walking along with breathing exercises would be very important. So after about 30 minutes of normal walking, and you can start stretching when you are sitting in a chair, you can do some kind of stretch. It leads to your muscle relax, and it gives us a very good blood flow to the whole body, and you will be stress free. So a lot of different things count as exercise, like dancing, walking, gardening, yoga, cycling, and playing basketball. These are the things for different age groups, and it can be followed. Stretching, breathing, and resistance exercise, I already discussed. Stretching should be 1/2 hour, breathing should be 1/2 hour, and resistance should be 15 minutes. So it should be included in your regular exercise. So it three have been having a better result along with the diet. So like a few tips for exercise. Do a brisk walk for 5 minutes while picking up your morning papers or milk which has been thrown out of your house. Do treadmill walk if you are not able to go for a walk. At least 1/2 hour you go for it. If the rainy season, if you have been riding everywhere, if you are not able to go during corona season, you can go out of it. Better, you can half an hour, you can go for a treadmill. In a rainy season, you can go for a treadmill. So do 100 counts of push-ups. I think it can't be possible. If you do 100 counts of push-ups over the kitchen counter while cooking, not like a it's like leaning in the stairs or leaning in a table, you can do 100 push-ups. Playing outside with your kids and friends, it gives you more amount of happy hormones, and you can be having a good amount of energy. So a simple stretch can be done in your workplace. So don't sit for at least 2 hours in a chair. You just every 2 hours, give a gap, do a stretch, and stretch for 5 minutes. And then see, we doctors like sit for more than 8 hours in a day. So definitely we have been facing many problems, many kind of other stress. So every 2 hours, if you give a stretch, there will be a better improvement in your health. So dance for your favorite music, wear a pedometer, aim for 10,000 steps every day. Use the stair instead of elevator and escalator everywhere possible. Get off the bus stop and walk for the rest of the way. If you have been going in the bus, just get on before the stop and start walking. So purposefully park your car a little further and from your home and for a store. So these are the single steps or simple steps you can be followed every day. Regarding the diabetic control, is diabetes curable? Many patients ask me, sir, is diabetes curable? No, it's not curable. The fact it is can be really controlled. Because nowadays there are the many programs in the YouTube or the social medias, diabetes can be controlled. How you can control? Because the our metabolic disorder, which leads to the decrease in insulin secretion, then how you can be replaced? No, it can be controlled. It's not curable. Because if you start reducing your weight, or if you start reducing your diet intake or physical activity, if you increase your physical activity, you can be controlled without drugs or any other kind of thing for more than 5 years. In the initial 5 years, without drugs, you can control your diabetes along with the diet and exercise. It's really possible. But if you're not doing the diet and exercise properly, then it's not be possible. Sir, I'm doing all kind of things, exercise and things, but you are not stick to your plan correctly. You have been following for 1 month, and after a month, it's training, sir, some other kinds of things you have, excusing you are giving. No, it can't be controlled. If it is diabetic, is curable. Many patients can be curable. It can be controlled. It's not curable. So what is diabetic? It's a metabolic disorder. It decreases in insulin secretion, leads to increased in the blood glucose level in the body. There are two types of diabetes. The most common one is type 2. The other one is type 1. The most common type 2 diabetes, it can be controlled with the drugs and insulin. The type 1 is completely insulin dependent. You have the life for lifelong, they has to be insulin dependent. The type 1 majorly occurs in below 20 years of period. For the younger ones, like both boys and girls, it has been due to autoimmune disorder. It has been possibly some kind of genetic problems. It has been happening in the nowadays, like type 1. It completely depends on insulin. No drugs can be controlled type 1 patients. No OHS or no other tablets can control type 1. Type 1 is completely dependable on insulin. Type 2, it has a different pathway. You can control with diet, physical activity, drugs, and insulin. So these are the four things can be accepted for type 2 diabetes. So how to prevent from diabetes and its complications? It's already discussed, diet and exercise. Avoid direct sugars. Avoid direct sugars. And as I said, start thinking about the nutritional facts and about the sugar level and salt level and other kind of products when you start getting to your home in the dining table. So how to prevent from diabetes? It's a balanced diet. Balanced diet, I already explained, it should be a good portion of carbohydrate, good carbohydrate, and a fiber, protein, and good vegetables. So as I think madam has clearly explained that red color, green color, and the proteins. You can take a fish, a small fish, but it should not be fried. It has to be like in curry. You can take with the sabjis, and you can take with the. But if you can't allow non-vegetarian all day, so monthly once you can take, or 2 weeks for 3 weeks once you can take. So you can't just continuously taking of non-vegetarian. The portion should be in the limited size, and you have to reduce your carbohydrate. So this is a balanced diet. Stress-free lifestyle. For a stress-free lifestyle, I think madam has discussed everything like yoga. You have to be happy and everything at the same. So regular monitoring of blood glucose level. Regular monitoring and regular, there are the 7 steps to prevent diabetes. Be more active, eat rich fibers food, rich food, eat whole grain, lose weight, make healthier choices, don't smoke, and drink in the moderate. I can't accept that, but if you having some kind of friends activities monthly, once or twice a month, you can have a drink. So if your patient is suffering from diabetes, these are the symptoms they have: excessive thirst, fatigue. They go for frequent urination, blurred vision, and weight loss. So these are the symptoms. If your patient has been diabetic, they have to go for a treatment. So definitely, if the patient, if the HbA1c was so high, they may be end up with insulin. If the HbA1c was low or it is 8 or something, you can go for a tablet. So these are the symptoms has to be followed. These are the main symptoms for diabetes. So regarding the investigation, when you are going to be a diabetic, it has to be a GTT, that is a glucose tolerance test. If a patient is on diabetic, if you have been suffering from diabetic for more than 2 years, it should be, they can go for a fasting blood glucose, postprandial, and glycated hemoglobin. This is a glycated hemoglobin, means it shows a 3 months of your average. So the past 3 months, how you've been in the diet, according to your physical activity, how you have behaved, how your drugs has respond. So these are the things which should be reflected by the glycated hemoglobin. So fasting should be less than 100. So after a meal, it can be 130 to 140. Regarding the exercise, it should be 100. So the HbA1c of average 3 months, it should be below 7. If it is below 7, you are been in the good control. So diabetes is a lifelong condition. Actually, with serious complications like diabetic retinopathy, neuropathy, nephropathy, stroke, and cardiovascular. If you start reducing your weight along with physical activity, along with stress-free activity, definitely if you have been diabetic in the initial period, if you have been diabetic at the age of 40, if you start controlling your diabetes to 40 to 45, if your HbA1c is 7 from 40 to 45, you have been free from risk at least for 15 years. If your sugar goes up after 50, if it is go 300, definitely you can't be worried, or you don't need to worry about the complication. In the first 5 years, if you are not controlled your HbA1c or the sugar value, definitely if you are not been controlling your HbA1c for 5 years, you may definitely you will end up with the complications. So these are the things has to be taken care of in the initial 5 years. When you have been recently diagnosed or newly diagnosed, the first 5 years is the more crucial period. If you start controlling the blood sugar level below 7 in the first 5 years, you will be free from the diabetic complications. So way to control diabetes: eat healthy, be active, and start including grains. Like in Tamil, we say Sirudhaniyangal, and about brown rice, Kai Kuttal Arasi. So these are the things will reduce your carbohydrate and reduce your sugar level. So if you start taking off 4 meal, 3 meal, definitely it also reduces your blood sugar level. So diabetic control: regular intake of medicines as prescribed. So these are the drugs which has been available in the market, like glipizide, metformin, Tradjenta, or glipizide, or the insulins. Insulin be the safer side. If your patient have been, the OH has not been working for a longer time, the insulin be the better drug. It reduces your blood sugar level absolutely without any side effects. But these drugs which have been available in the market, every drug has its own side effect. It may end up, or it may damage your kidney. It may end up, damage your stomach and liver. But insulin is the safer drug which won't cause any harm. I've seen patients taking insulin for more than 50 years, which won't affect any organs. Like DG Balaji sir asked, sir, I've been taking insulin for 30 years. Sir, you have been safe. Because the drugs cause another kind of increase your urea level, creatinine level. If insulin won't cause any harm to your body. But nowadays in social media, the YouTube, there has been saying about, you are taking insulin, you are going to, your kidney will be affected. No, I have seen patients 50 years of taking insulin, their kidney, their other parameters are absolutely controlled. I've seen patients taking drugs, they end up within 10 years, they end up with other cardiovascular disorder, nephropathy, kidney disease, and diabetic retinopathy. These other things can happen. So insulin is the safest medicine. And regular monitoring of sugar level by maintaining a sugar chart, it's very important. It gives you the correct picture, and it gives you the information what you are taking, how your body responds. So these are the chart has to be maintained. Regular follow-up review as the consultant says. An ophthalmic review as per the ophthalmologist, and start checking your eye every consult. Every year you have to take care of your retinal photography. So it gives us a better picture. So these are the things has to be followed. Review periodically, revise your prescriptions, normalize blood glucose and other parameters, prevent from diabetes complications, and lead a healthy lifestyle. So remember to consult your doctors regularly. Your blood sugar keep fluctuating. Medicines are prescribed based on your current test. Reports need to be reviewed and adjusted. Most of the complications are asymptomatic. So if you are eye is affecting due to the diabetic retinopathy, you won't know. Some patients say I have been having the normal eye. So if you start screening only, you can know whether your eye has changes or not. So these are the newer facilities which has been facilities available. Ambulatory glucose monitoring. Ambulatory glucose monitoring is a new device which has been available in the market. It is a patch. So it will be sticked in the arm. So it gives us a 14 days of your blood sugar level with every reading, each and every reading, 14 days, it will give you a complete picture. So it is very helpful for GDM, gestational diabetes and type 1 diabetes mellitus. Glucose monitoring devices and every minute, it gives us a 14 days of consolidation blood glucose regarding detect the hyperglycemia and hypoglycemia. Facilitated dose adjustments. Like take home messages, stay healthy in all means. Work on both physical and mental strength. Lifestyle modification is to be a healthy and fit, along with the stress management. If you start approaching the weight management with a holistic approach, you will be free from diabetes and your diabetes can be controlled. Thank you.